Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, Chris here, and in today's video we're going to be checking out the all new Soundtoys Super Plate. Let's go. Alright, and we're back baby, on to the Super Plate. So Soundtoys have released a new plugin. They rarely release new plugins, so it's a very exciting day. And I am quite excited about this one because this kind of originates from a plugin that they've had for a while called the Little Plate. The Little Plate is simply the most basic of reverbs emulating a EMT-140 reverb plate, a popular choice amongst a lot of musicians and producers. But this expands on that and gives us a whole new world of things to play with, and I'm quite excited for one feature in particular which I would like to try out, but let's dive in. So starting us off, this is the Super Plate, right? So this is what it looks like. Very user-friendly looking plugin, but with a couple of variations that maybe you haven't seen before. So to start us off, I'm just gonna rock us from left to right. Let's start on this side. These are all of the different types of reverb plates. So to test us off, I've just got a piano sound. No reverb. Just gonna send it to the plate. Already sounds really nice. A bit dark, you know, sits behind the piano really lovely. Let's just have a quick flick throughout all the different types and see what variations we're getting. So this is the 140 again. Sweet. So they're all pretty subtle, especially if you're listening on your phone. But maybe if you've got some headphones, you can hear a bit of the differences going on. So I had to get up the manual because I really wanted to know about all of these different types of plates. So I've got the manual up here, and I'm just going to quickly break down what all of these different type of plates are. I mean, I can explain the first two. So we've got the classic 140, which is an EMT plate famously used amongst across the world. It's just if there's a plate in a studio, it's probably going to be that. Been around since like the 1950s, and you know, it was basically created as a way to emulate a whole reverb but without needing a hole. So they've just got this big piece of sheet metal that they send sound through, and then there's a pickup on the other side of the metal, and it will literally pick up what the sound is once it passes through this big piece of sheet metal. And that's what you get. Reverb. Next up, we've got this gold foil 240. This is also emulating an EMT reverb plate, which is the 240, slightly smaller, slightly darker. It was meant to be, it was meant to fit a lot better in a space. So that was kind of the idea behind it. But then it ended up becoming quite popular amongst pro producers, I guess, to use as a reverb. But saying that, wasn't as kind of commonly found in studios. So next, this is where it becomes a bit new for me. So the Odcon is based on what is commonly known as the Plate 2 by Lawson in the 70s, and quite notably used in Nashville for being more punchy and having more sparkle than the EMT-140. So we can give it a quick comparison. I imagine the EMT would just be a bit darker. Yeah, brighter, you know, just a bit more stereo even. Yeah, the 140 just feels a bit darker, a bit more contained, you know. Then we have the E-Plate 3, which is based on a model of the Echo Plate 3. Let's see, built by Jim Cunningham of Studio Technologies in Illinois back in the 80s. It's styled after the EMT, but the sound is on the brighter side. That sounds good on percussion, brass, and high harmonic content, apparently. Famously used in the 80s by Michael Jackson, Quincy Jones, George Benson. Fantastic, that's great to know. Sounds like that. So the fifth plate is modeled after the Stocktronics RX4000 plate reverb, which is a Swedish plate reverb. Only 250 units were made and has a unique sound, as the cold forge stainless steel plate is only 0.3 millimeters thick, which makes it sound very bright and adds tons of character. Definitely bright. I would say bright ones are that Stocktronics, the Odcon. See that E-plate. Oh, dark. And yeah, the 240 is a bit brighter. And then the 140 is sitting a bit on the darker side as well. So that's basically the five plates. You know, normally we're just sticking with the 140, the little plate based off that 140. But now where things get a bit interesting is underneath we've got these three buttons right now. These are basically the EMT 140, besides just being a plate reverb, it needed to pass sound through it, right? So they had to put a preamp inside the reverb. So that was more of a tube preamp. So you can even drive the preamp, you know, get a bit of saturation and compression out of it. As well as this, which is based on a transistor style. I've read in the manual that they also, if you drive the input, it adds a bit of compression to help with transients and stuff. That was made in the original machine to, you know, avoid the transistor overloading when you send too much signal through it. So it was just a standard compressor that you couldn't actually change the settings of. But apparently in this, if we stick it on and push up the input, it will actually compress the signal for us. So I'd love to check that out. But yeah, so we have this tube, this transistor, and then this, which represents a resistor, and it's just meant to be the cleanest sound without any additional coloration. These two, the tube and the transistor, were only included in the 140 style plates, but Soundtoys were like, you know, let's allow them to add coloration to all the reverbs. So they've put those in the chain, and I believe they'll you know, add a little bit of coloration or saturation harmonics, you know, to whichever one of the reverbs you choose, or you have the option to leave it truly clean on the resistor option without any additional coloration. So with that first section out of the way, I'd love to just get some sound. So let's find, I'll use Labs because that's always got something inspiring going on. Let's find maybe some strings. That's dry. Let's add some of that plate and see how it sounds. Get a bit more in there going. Let's change the reverb. Wow, I love that Stocktronics one on the strings. Very subtle. If I crank it. Oof. Beautiful. And without the reverb, one more time. Full fat reverb. Lovely, that's sitting so nicely. I'd love to try these tube and the transistor. So let's go back on the 140 and just hear it without it. And then we'll stick the tube on. Okay, transistor. Very subtle. Okay, but let's drive it a bit, see what we're getting. Can hear that. Transistor. Wow, a lot less low end coming out of the transistor than the tube. And then with nothing. Ooh, yeah. Nice. Interesting that you got those kind of extra bits of coloration going on, and the compression is great. Let's check out this middle section now. I've got a bit of filtering, pre-delay, modulation, and the depth, obviously. So I'm just going to pick a random one. Let's chuck it on the tube and let's play with these a bit. I know that this decay time is based on the room time, apparently at like 500 hertz, because room times vary depending what frequency you're on, but normally a plate reverb will last about 5 seconds, more or less. But with the power of technology, you can obviously extend that room time to whatever you want. So I've got it really short or infinite. That's actually quite lush on its own. But I know the longest it can go without being infinite is around 1 minute. So you got plenty of length in there. But yeah, so we've got that. We've got some filters. So if I put this on pre-fader, so I've just taken out all of the dry signal and now we're only hearing the reverb. So we can see what the filters are doing. Lovely, and we've got a little bit of modulation that's just going to be changing the pitch slightly to add almost a chorusy effect, but apparently it can get pretty insane. Sick, let's get the dry signal back in. Turn the reverb down slightly. Sick. So that is our main kind of page of the superplate. Let's check this tweak mode where we get a few further options as well as something I'm very excited to try, which is this auto-decay. Now, a technique which is commonly used amongst using reverb and delay is that, say you've got a singer, the reverb or the delay might be taking up a lot of space while the singer is singing, so you wanna duck it out the way. So you would use a compressor that's side-chained to the lead voice or to the instrument that you're using. And basically every time sound comes out of that instrument or someone sings or whatever it may be, it's gonna duck all of the effects out of the way, which is really convenient because then when they stop singing, it brings them all back and you know, it makes it feel like they were never gone in the first place, which is great. But this is kind of playing on a similar concept, which is when I'm going to use the context of a singer. Say a singer is performing, you know, they're singing, and you don't want the reverb to muddy up all of their verse or whatever, so you would normally pull it back. In this case, what this is doing is, instead of just pulling back the overall sound, the overall volume of the reverb, it's changing the decay time in the sense that when a person is singing or when the level is passing the threshold, the decay time will be short, and then when it stops, it's going to open up and become a lot longer, which, you know, makes room for that vocal. So you still have the kind of wetness in there, but it's not taking up all of that room and that headspace that will, you know, muddy up your mix. So let's see if I can find a vocal line.
Don't you think like that, I will love you endlessly, if you don't believe in me.
Great, we've got our dry vocal. I'm gonna slap some reverb on it.
Don't you think like that, I will love you endlessly, if you don't believe in me.
So you can see it coming up on the threshold. Let's play with the decay and see what it sounds like.
Don't you think like that, I will love you endlessly, if you only believe in me. Don't you be like that, I will love you forever, if you only believe in me. Yeah.
Awesome. So our recovery is kind of like our release, you know, how quickly it's going to snap back to that long reverb time. But actually, if I just get to the end of this line, we can hear what the tail sounds like.
Believe in me. Yeah.
Lovely. So I've got the target set to the shortest possible reverb time, and then here it's set to about 4 or 5 seconds. So
believe in me. Yeah.
And it's great because while she's singing, it's at the shortest time, you know, it's going to 0.5 of a second, And that just means that throughout her verse, she's pretty clear until she comes out of it. Ooh, until she comes out of it. And then we get that full fat reverb.
Don't you think like that? I will love you endlessly if you don't believe in me. Don't you be like that?
Lovely. That's super convenient because, you know, like I said, you still get that kind of wetness from the reverb, but it's not taking up the whole space of her vocal. Like if I had this off, for example, you'd hear it would be a completely different, you know, mix with the clarity of her vocal.
Don't you think like that? I will love you endlessly.
As opposed to
if you don't believe in me.
So much clearer, you know.
Don't you be like that?
And there's a couple of methods you can use to help with the same thing. It's even, you know, adding some pre-delay. So when she says a word, it's not the first word she says, a reverb instantly comes out. You give it time for her to say what she's saying, and then the reverb slowly follows behind it, which will also help. Say I take off this threshold and we're just playing with the pre-delay.
Don't you think like that? I will love you endlessly if you don't believe in me.
So yeah, still long and quite out there, but it's not like they're happening at the same time, so it kind of fuses into just a really distant vocal. It's more like your voice is here and then the reverb is back here. It's not like they're living in the same space.
Don't you think like that? I will love you endlessly if you don't believe in me. Don't you be like that? I will love you forever.
But I guess a combo of the two would probably work really well, I'd imagine. So if I bring this threshold down and then give it some pre-delay. Clean up some of that low end. It's nice, you've got some control here over the EQ as well as, I guess, a couple of bells, which is quite nice to cut out any frequencies that are bugging you, which is lovely. And then the last two things I have to touch up on, which is the modulation rate and the stereo. Modulation rate will just be how quickly the pitch shifting is happening when you've got this cranked.
Don't you think like.
So if I pull this back down, so we just hear only the reverb. Modulation cranked, and we can speed up this. Very subtle on the modulation. I mean, before it was just a switch on and off type thing, so it is nice that you kind of have this amount slider in between. But I would say, yeah, super subtle, but it's nice that it's there. And then the stereo is basically, do you want it full stereo or do you want to fold it down to mono, which might be convenient if you're looking for a mono reverb.
If you don't believe in me, yeah.
Oh wow, this reverb does really sound lovely. Like just on this vocal alone, it's bringing a real lot of excitement. You know, it's just nice to have options with this stuff. Like I find, you know, you kind of sit on both sides of the fence where when you have too many options, you don't know what to do. And when you don't have enough options, sometimes you don't know what to do and you're just like a bit stuck. So I think this plate in particular is providing a real lot of nice sounds. I guess you just need to remember kind of which one is bright, which one is dark, and then pick accordingly. And if you want a little bit of extra flavor, you've always got it down here. But that auto-decay feature, oh, I'm a big fan. That sounds really nice and definitely going to be helping out with my mixes along the way. So that would be great. I'm going to find one more sound to kind of finish us off on, and then I shall conclude this video. Let's go to Keyscape. We've always got some nice sounds in there. Go on the Whirly. Doesn't disappoint. Sick. So we've got that. Let's add a bit of reverb. Or a lot of reverb. Can hear that pre-delay is coming in a bit late. A little delay on that. So if I bring the pre-delay back to the beginning. as opposed to here where it would be like a delay. So I want that on the zero. You can really hear that distortion from the tube. If I bring this back down, ain't anywhere as crunchy on the reverb. Beautiful, and let's try the transistor real quick. Can turn that auto-decay off, I think, for this. Alright, so I better conclude this video before my camera overheats one more time, because we're getting into the summer season, so it's picking up on the heat. But thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please leave us a comment below letting us know what you thought about the video. Again, I've really enjoyed the super plate, so I'd love to know your thoughts. If you've tried it, let us know. And don't forget to leave us a like and subscribe and all that stuff. It really supports the channel and I'm very grateful for it, so thank you very much if you've done that already. Once again, I've been Chris Vella, and I'll see you on the next one.